bullshit shit. Our internet is lovely tonight.
Goddamn Skype.
Blame you and your shitty shit. So yeah, alright, Kelly, I have no idea what the fuck's going on. Skaggy just got splooge on his face from a spider.
Damn spider.
So he gets to roll his first 20 for the night and see if he can escape. Make a dexterity check and see whether you can escape getting caught.
What are you doing,
Dad? All right, I'm ready.
Roll 20. What are you doing? Get on it. Do it.
So I just want to know what happened. Like, I still don't know.
You're making a dex check. Do your shit.
I'm making a dex check? Was that official?
Yep. All right. Yep, that's official. Make your dex check. Give a roll on D20, 20-sided dice. You get to add your dexterity bonus.
Oh.
I get to add my dex?
Yep. Which your next bonus,
I think, is plus two, so I'm at 18. So I think I dodged the spooge.
Which is good, because the only other way to get out of it is to break it with a strength check. And
Skaggy's strength is, I believe, not too hot. 11.
Oh, it's huge. It's like negative one.
That's a zero.
A zero would be a positive for him.
Yeah, so you're able to dodge the webs that a spider kind of threw at you.
Nice.
And you and...
Retosh?
You and Retosh can roll initiative.
I just did.
19 for Retosh.
Oh, shoot.
20 for Skaggy!
Skaggy is a 20.
No!
And Retosh has a 5.
And Retosh has a...
get
a
8.
Few bonuses. 8. And Carr's not in this one. And...
Godric is not in this.
God. Yeah, Godric, we're not in this.
I know, dude. I don't have to dodge no splooge.
Sounds like he's jealous to me. That's
I'm
what I'm
saying. Roll another 20, God. Though, Retosh.
Uh-oh. I don't like that. Something happened to Retosh. This is bad.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Good job. Yes.
Okay. So, Skaggy gets to go first. Dropping down from above are two spiders.
Two spiders just drop down.
Yep. Drop them from the webs above.
What are spiders scared of? I'm about to meta.
Spider! Fucking burn the village to the ground, bitch! Bring hands, those bitches!
Well, if Kelly wasn't so quick with his GM shit, I was gonna tell these guys that I wanted to burn the whole fucking city down. But, you know, now shit happens. So... I'm trying to think of what would scare a spider. Like, are spiders scared of dogs? Or what if I created a bear, like a bear? Would they be scared of bears? I don't know what they're scared of.
Bear? Spiders are scared of
bears.
Spider. So, okay. So, where are the spiders in relation to me? You said they drop down. Are they dropping down like on top of me, Kelly? In front of me? Behind me?
They're about 50 feet above you.
50 feet above me. All right. Well... Desperate times call for desperate measures. So, what I'm about to do is...
Oh, God.
Yeah, it's about to get real up in here.
Where's Where's Carr and Godrick? Why am I the only one? Why am I here with Skaggy by myself?
Because we're smart, okay? Me and Carr are the smart bitches.
Yeah, I'm not even thinking about this. I'm going to hurl some acid. I'm gonna fire off a cantrip, acid splash. So I'm gonna hurl a bubble of acid up
over here.
Are you kidding me?
Straight above you.
Okay. Yep. Straight above me. Here we go. Let's do this.
That's what you're doing to us right now.
Let's get this going.
Seriously.
Hi.
So what do I gotta do, Kelly? It looks like. And it can hit two creatures.
Hey, is she adopted or what?
So the target must succeed on a dex.
I got a white wipe.
No.
Take 1d6 damage, Kelly.
Let's see. Acid splash.
I'll be right back.
Oh, is she supposed to go to bed? No, she's so much fun. Aww.
Dex saving throw or 1d6 damage.
Okay. So you give it a nice hurdle straight up, and the spider kind of swings out of the way, and it melts a big hole in the spider's in the webs above.
Nice. It didn't. Both of the spiders dodged it.
Hold on. By any chance, did it actually kick the spider's web that was coming out of its ass so that way it would fall to the ground?
No, doesn't appear to. They're still hanging up there.
Sorry, dude. Try to help you.
Okay. Can't quite do anything.
Since Retosh is gone,
so
you want to flip back to
the
ship?
It's the spiders. Turn.
Oh no, he wants to combat. He wants to kill those bitches.
And one of them tried to web Skaggy, and the other one is webbing. And let's see. Skaggy has an armor class. What's your armor class, Skaggy?
Low.
12?
Low.
Oh yeah, that hit. And Retosh has a better armor class now.
Yeah, Retosh is like 18.
Still got him. So you both need to do a save.
Retosh is not available at this moment.
So who wants to roll for him real quick?
D20. I can do it, but last time I did I rolled ones, so I'm going to do it.
So I just rolled an 8.
It's a 5.
Hold on.
Godric's wrong.
Hold on. No, it happened. It's fucking done. Yeah. I rolled a 5 for him.
Okay, so you've both been webbed.
Retosh, roll a d20 real quick. All right, save
yeah,
yourself.
Hurry, because you got a 5 or a 7.
I'll let Retosh roll. Go ahead.
14. There's Retosh.
Do you have a bonus there?
17.
So you are able. You succeeded. You dodged it. Skaggy, on the other hand, is a big ball of gray silk. And he's starting to get lifted up into the air.
Oh.
Bye, Skaggy.
I turn around and I run the other way. Back to the ship.
Son of a bitch. You are not doing that. Shut up, Howard.
Do it.
Who's Howard?
I only know Retosh. I'm getting the fuck out of here, dude.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I'm chaotic neutral. This is too crazy for me, man. I told you to use burning hands.
So is that what you're doing? You're heading for the ship, Retosh?
No. I'm gonna get my. I'm gonna use my. Is it my turn? I guess I'm up.
Yep, you're up.
I use my crossbow and I'm gonna shoot the one that's pulling him up.
Okay.
Or
shoot the web, dude. Shoot the web.
Oh yeah, thread the fucking needle and split the rope.
Yeah, I'm gonna aim for its butt. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
Nice. You're gonna shoot him in the ass.
Shoot him in the ass.
Right.
All right.
Ass-tastic, baby.
20.
Come on, Retosh. Come on.
You hit Skaggy.
Oh, dude.
Four.
Oh, my
Close
God.
Close enough. You hit Skaggy.
So, that bolt's gone.
And you're left. Sorry, dude.
You just see it in a web going like this and shit, still moving from the force.
It got caught.
So, yeah.
He's a pretty heavy set dwarf, so it probably takes a while for the spider to pull him up.
You're hoping it does.
I can get another shot off before.
Yep, you can roll initiatives, Skaggy. Go ahead and roll initiative.
Oh, I'm rolling, Kelly. I'm rolling. Oh, like, I'm in this, but that doesn't mean that I'm completely tied up. I will burn myself to the ground before I get eaten by a spider.
Burn it. On himself, he's like, ah!
Kangy, what'd you get?
I got a 14.
And.
13 for me.
Hey, Carr, we don't have to do anything.
I know. Don't you love this?
Alright, Skaggy gets to go first.
You're relying on those cards, aren't you?
They're good,
you
man.
You can't really move your hand, so anything that requires a gesturing component, you can cast.
Yeah, but I'm thinking...
you can try and do a strength check to break out.
A what?
Strength check to break out.
Yeah, now you're just mocking me, Kelly. So
you're pretty strong. You need a 17.
At St. Patty's Day, drink Killian's or Guinness.
Don't you have a dagger
or whiskey?
I do. I have a dagger and an axe. The dagger would have been in my hand, but the axe, I don't know if, because I was doing a spell.
It's
so
on his back, like he's just like.
Mine's Scottish. Sorry.
Wouldn't Kelly? Wouldn't he be able to like kind of reach his dagger and cut himself out? Versus a strength check.
So once you're entangled in it, it's kind of hard to cut your way free. I could give him a bonus maybe on that, but that's about. You're still only got limited movement if you can't move your arm to cut yourself free.
So Kelly, I need an official ruling here. I'm considering using shocking grasp. Do you think that would travel through the web to the spider? I think it would conduct. I think spider web material is conductive because it's made, you know, it's water based.
Like he shocking grasps his own body.
Oh yeah, dude, grass. I'm gonna be fucked by it too. But I'm fucking.
And then he splooges. See, it's a cycle that happens.
I am fucking that spider up, man.
You're fucking yourself up.
Okay, go ahead and roll if you want.
Well, hold on, man. You got to tell me if this is going to... if there's
No,
any
he
potential.
Doesn't have to tell you shit. Do what you're doing. Shocking grasp your ass and see if it fucking electrifies the spider.
All right, I'm doing this. I'm doing it.
Oh, man, this is awesome.
I'm going to laugh when you break your own armor class and fucking kill yourself. Oh, no.
Alright, so I just rolled a 3, but what's my bonus for that? Is it...
So you're just trying to shock the webs around you?
I'm shocking anything that's touching me, which includes the web. The web gets a lightning strike.
Let's see. Alright.
So I get like a +2 or something to that, don't I?
It's like, I get a +18, I'm sure of it. I know
this. But what were you rolling for, John?
Damage. Damage.
Oh, for damage. Okay.
Yep. It's 1d8 lightning damage.
What'd you roll? You rolled an 8 and you got a 3?
Yeah. But I get, like I said, is there any bonus that gets added to that? That's what I couldn't remember.
It's your intelligence, isn't it?
If it says spell power, then it's your... either wisdom or intelligence. Which is both +4.
Other thing. It loosens the web enough and delivers a shock back to you. You take 3 damage, but you do slide out of the webs and fall another 10 feet in the air for another
and take
six
fall damage.
Damage.
Yes, give him fall damage. Yes,
that's fine.
So that's 9 that you took.
I can
total.
I can take it.
You took 9 damage. You dealt 3, and you took a fucking yep.
Go ahead. Who's laughing now, bitches? I'm out of this item bed.
Hey, me and Carr are safe in a fucking ship, okay? We're just chilling. I'm just talking to Gringle like I'm just shooting the shit, dude.
So,
we hanging out. What's up?
Yeah,
the
like
spider that was up there that was pulling you up, when you fall from its thing, it drops down onto you and tries to bite you.
Did the spider take his turn or something?
Yeah, this is
yeah,
it right now.
Taking it, that's its turn right now.
Do I get to do any kind of like a...
No.
No, he attacks your bitches.
All right. The other one shoots a web at Retosh again. All right.
So remember when Godric said burn the village to the ground? Might have been a good idea.
I know, dude.
Oh, I don't have one. All right. And, Retosh, you got to roll your save. And is that your 20 for the save?
Yeah, I got a 9.
All right. So now you're webbed. And an arrow comes flying out and pierces the spider that was trying to drop on Skaggy and kills it.
Dang.
And now it's Retosh's turn. You're webbed, but you can try a strength check to break free if you want.
Yeah. 20.
20-sided dice, you need a 17.
Ooh. Yeah,
he gets it,
and you got it. So he rips and shreds and breaks all of the web around.
And there's still another spider up above, right?
Yep. So it's another round.
Okay, so roll again.
Yep. 20s again.
Boom. I'm killing it on initiative.
Boom.
It's another 20, Kelly.
All right.
Roll a 20, Howard.
Oh, you did.
I know, but you can't do shit for anything else. Shocking grasp. 3 damage.
Yeah, but he has a 15 on...
He's lucky he didn't do any more. Let's say that.
So I go first, Kelly?
Yep, go for it.
Okay, and there's still a spider up there, right?
Yep. And Jess, all right, so go ahead with your 20. You get a first.
And what was that?
Let's go first.
Hey, is she supposed to be in bed?
Yep.
I thought you already took her to bed, didn't you? No?
Yeah.
Like cool, dude.
He's a softie. He's a big
cool, dude. I'm not knocking.
All right. One more time, Kelly.
You're up. There's one spider hanging from a thread up above that had just webbed Retosh, but he rolled and broke his way free of the web, knocking it off, so he's free. But there's one spider above you.
Alright, so, like, I'm going to do a badass move where I'm going to kick this dead spider off of me, jump to my feet, pull out a dagger, and I'm going to whip a dagger at this other spider. And I'm going to aim right for its butt.
Alright. Roll that 20.
I'm not magic. Ooh, not bad. So I know you did
it. Plus your dex, because it's a finesse weapon, but if you're proficient.
So at the very beginning, Kelly told me I had a proficiency bonus of +2, but I don't think it applies to...
Yeah.
Does that apply to the daggers?
Yep.
Okay.
So, let's see. I'm going to look at your actions here. When you are using a dagger, you have +4 to hit.
Okay, cool. So 16.
And that hits. Nice. So it's 1d4 +2.
Nice, 5.
Okay.
So I basically jammed that dagger right up its butt, right?
All right. So nice. You damaged it. Dagger stuck in it. Pretty nice. Good. It's not happy about it. And it's Ritosh, your turn.
It's still... So I'll shoot at it with my crossbow.
Sure.
As I grab the webs off of it, and
yeah, not quite so good on the crossbow that time. Ooh. Spider decides to engage, and it drops down on top of Ritosh and bites him.
Mm.
And he got a natural 20.
Boom! Bite him in the face! Actually, cut his hair off with his pincers. Can you do that? I don't want to be the only bald bitch.
So you need to roll, you take 6 damage, and you need to roll versus poison. So a 20-sided.
Oh,
I am.
Nice.
Yeah. Yep.
How much damage?
Good there. 6.
Okay.
Oh, that's nice.
That's what she said.
I love how he comes back with 2 beers. I mean, you know, I got the bottle of whiskey right next to me, you know? I mean, why fucking move?
Well, I want to save that.
And the spider is ripped to shreds by Gale.
Nice.
Saved by the doggy. So Jeff steps out of the building. He has his bow in his hands. He fired the one arrow that killed the one spider, and he's looking up above to see if there's any more. It's like, and the old man with the white beard is going, "Oh, you killed! Oh, well, I suppose I could take a sample. That would be cool." And he's walking over, trying to take a little dagger and scoop a leg and see if he could get something into a jar and. Running back inside to preserve his samples.
Where did Jess go?
When they attacked, he fired from inside through the doorway and shot one of the spiders. They stepped out, and he's just standing there, kind of with you guys, looking up above. Say, we got to get out of here.
He's the one that shot the skaggy one.
Okay. Yep. And.
So I say, want
to flip now back to the.
Hold on.
Did we find patients?
Hold on. Right before we flip, I want to leave us with a cliffhanger. So when Jess says, "I want to get out of here," I look at Jess and I say, "We're going to exit this building, and I'm going to burning hands those spiders that are hanging up above, and I'm going to burn this whole town down." And now we should flip over to Godric.
My house.
Now we should flip over to Godric's car.
And you motherfucker.
Oh, so something it, I suggested so it, like fucking an hour ago you now want to do.
That's what I'm saying, man.
What happened with the acid splash before we cut? I missed it.
Oh, nothing. It missed.
He fucking missed.
It missed. It fucking almost killed you, dude.
Yeah, at least it freaking killed me. That's all I was freaking worried about.
So, inside.
Next time I go to Skag, remind me not to.
So what are you guys doing here?
Okay, so we're talking to the guys, right? That
yep.
We came in. Godric, smartass, thankfully.
Yeah, I'm like, where did we come
to
from?
The
outside, we walked in the door. What do you mean, where did we come from?
Not too many people were brave walking underneath a spider's web.
Well, you're here. How did you get here?
Oh,
I'm assuming you walked
here.
In through the same door we did.
I woke up here, dude.
Wait, what do you mean woke up here?
He lives here.
He lives in the ship in the middle of a town where there's no water.
So, was this boat in the middle of the ocean? Was this boat in the middle of the ocean, or are you just here now? Like, do you know you're on land?
Haven't been drinking that much.
So, did you guys build the ship just to have it in the middle of the town, or were you hoping for water?
I'm going to pull some meta stuff right now. I have a sailing background. Would I know why this ship is fucking here?
Let me see your meta. Let me see your sailing card.
It's not a sailing card, dude. It's my fucking background.
Prove it.
It's on my fucking character sheet. Kelly has
on your character sheet,
Howard, Mr. Meta.
Scan it in. Scan it in and send it to me.
I have fucking 50 feet of silk rope. And my shit is running. Hold on.
Woo, we got the metal horn right police going. Woo, woo.
That's from my sailing background.
So, you know that this was a real ship at one time, though it's been obviously quite a few years since it's ever seen water. But it had seen water. You could see bracken still remain scars on the outside where the water line would have been. So, this ship was one that had seen water, and it's now been on the ground. The scars that the one guy holds, as a sailor, you recognize he was keel-hauled. And that's where all the scars came from. So, you know, you could...
But
as a sailor, you know that those are
like
sailor scars. And you could tell from the tattoos that the other guy is brandishing that at one time he was a sailor, too. He is... too old to be a sailor anymore. He's a sailor's grandpa.
Okay, so I reach into my bag, and I'm assuming there's like a counter shelf or something in this place. And
Several tables, and there's been hooks and lanterns added to the wall, so this is a functioning, excuse me, inn. Inner hold is now a tavern.
Okay, I reach into my bag and I pull out some silver thing. That's what Carr sees, but it's something to kind of prove that I'm one of them. And I put it down on the counter. And I'm like, tell me what's been going on here, friend.
Well, that's what I kind of wanted. I was wondering if you could shed some light on it. We woke up this morning and there's all these damn spiders taken all over the town. Most people have locked themselves inside their buildings, but half the town's gone, too. You wouldn't have to know anything about this, would you?
No, we met this kid, Jess, on the way in. He was out hunting. Do you know him?
Yeah, I know him.
Okay, we met him coming in, and he was out hunting last night, and we kind of followed him back. We're looking for this tomb, and we just, you know, he said, someone might know at the tavern, so we came in here and kind of asking for directions, and we ran into this and figured we could help out.
So you're adventurers, huh? Dungeon crawlers.
That's one word for what we do. I like to keep an open mind.
I would like to think that we are explorers.
He can explore whatever he wants. Again. I don't like
you guys can both roll a 20 for me, please.
All right.
Ah, shit.
Well, of course I roll a 9. I should get some plus sailor bonus. God damn it.
Hold on, give me a second here.
Woohoo!
Wait, what are you rolling for?
I don't have no idea. Okay. Lower's better, though.
I have a 13. No matter what I have, I have at least plus one.
So, well, maybe you can help us then. There's at least half the people in this town. There's about 20 people that disappeared in the night. There's lots of humans and spider tracks all over the place. You know, we knew there was a big spider nest to the east of here. We always stayed away from it. That must be where they all came from. But why they came out, I don't know.
As he's talking to me, I pick up my silver coin and I'm floating it between my fingers, rolling it up and down, and just kind of sitting there thinking.
So one of them says, "My name is Hark Longarm." Another guy goes, "I'm Seth Frinston, but you can call me Keel."
I go over to him and I give him the Spartan forearm like handshake, you know. I feel like that's what a pirate would do. So yeah, that's kind of what I do. Good to meet you. I'm Godric.
You can tell by some of the tattoos that these two were pirates at one time.
Okay.
One of them points and says, "This is Cap Galen."
I kind of look over to him and kind of, you know, bow my head a little bit in recognition.
So.
Can you fellas help us out navigating this town? We don't know. Where's everyone held up at? We had some people go to find, do you know who Precious is?
Yeah, she's just the east of here. First house over, straight east.
What's the deal with Jess and Precious? Like, what's the relationship there?
They're two youngins. They got sweet eyes for each other.
Okay. So, I'm not sure really what's going on. I've seen the spiders above, but I mean,
I don't think she's let them walk the plank, though, yet.
I give my face just goes completely like, I know exactly what you're talking about. And I look back at Carr and look back and where'd you say all the people were held up at?
We don't know. They just disappeared.
They disappeared. So, I mean, do you know who is left in the town? Have you not gone outside? Or, I mean, you guys are just holding up in here?
Well, we locked up Weston for looting. And there's a few of the boys are still around. Mick and Eaton. Flynn, they're, Drake, they're all still around. I think Crazy Doc and Precious made it.
How many people you got in this town?
Only about 40.
So because pretty much everyone's fucking gone.
So half the people are gone, have disappeared. The Mackies still seem to be around.
Alright, I mean, you have any place that's a good place to hunker down and get everyone into one location? Can you go around and kind of try to gather up everybody?
Nah, I don't. I think we're just gonna let them sit where they're at right now. But if you guys could go see if you can find some of them missing, maybe go to the spider's nest and figure out what drove them out. Maybe that'd be helpful.
Spider's nest. Where's that at? Know. We haven't seen that yet.
So, they pull out a piece of paper and pull out a little piece of kind of burnt wood, and they start drawing on the paper. Here's the town. They draw a little circle. If you go south and east here, right about here, they scratch on the piece of paper. This should be about the spot where you'll find the spiders. It's pretty easy to find. Just look for the damn webs.
All right. Well, we'll see what we can do.
All right. Flip back.
Oh. Okay, cool.
So,
hey, Carter didn't do the same shit. Sorry, buddy. They're my people.
No,
my
I
people.
Wouldn't ask. No, it's cool. Whatever.
So, Skaggy,
I don't want to talk to your ass. Anyway.
It just
You're
said
up.
That he's going to burn the place. And Jess looks at him in horror and says, "You can't burn my house down. All my stuff's in there."
No, Jess.
My wife, my mom is still around.
I don't want to burn down your house. I just want to burn down the spiders and the spider webs.
But they're on the house.
Well, there could be a little collateral damage. It's true.
They're on every house.
All right. Well,
keep, dude.
Here's the thing, Jess. We'll go back to the group. I'll tell them the plan. If they don't like the plan, we'll do something else, all right? But I said, we're going to have to be careful. Like, we're going to have to look around for these spiders. You know, like, five more spider bites and I'm out of here, man. So we gotta be careful.
So you get every house and get everybody out of the town. Then I'll let you burn it. Until then, you're going to have to go through me. And he's holding his bow like he's going to hit you with it.
I wish Godric was in this fucking room. Oh, my God. He would do the same shit he did to you, Skaggy.
I say, all right, let's go catch up with our friends. We'll figure out what's going on. So we're going to go head over to the boat, to inside the boat where they are.
Hey, so Kelly, how did we go through a hole to get in? I don't understand. Like, did we go under?
Yeah, you kind of went underneath. So think of it like a huge
canopy,
blanket,
like a circus
canopy, tent. like a circus tent.
That's being held
and
up by
somebody
the ship.
Cut a hole in part of it. You could see where they hacked at it with swords or something to cut a hole to cut some of it away. To make a gap big enough for you to get through. Now, Jess goes, "Come on, Precious, it's time to get out of here." He goes, no, I need her for testing. Does this itch? And he grabs, who generously called the doctor, grabs his daughter's arm and kind of rubs a leg on it. She's like, "Ah."
Well, I'm going to start running through the other houses and try to clear it out. Sorry, Kelly, I didn't know you were still going.
Okay, nope, that's fine.
Wait, I couldn't really hear you, Howard. What?
I'll let Kelly finish.
He said he was going to go through some houses and see. So immediately to your left, there's a small group of houses. Or you can go across a bigger gap to the south side of the ship. So you want to go across the north side or the south side? The ship
you're saying across, right?
Yeah. So think of it as a circle of houses around a big ship. Okay?
Okay. Okay.
You want to go circle north or circle south?
Which one did you say was closer? The north one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll go north.
Wait, so are you going by yourself then?
Yep.
Dude, he's in half orc. He's like fucking badass. What?
Okay. Well, he does that, we're going to head back to the ship. Me.
So,
yep. You guys are Skaggy now.
You start going that way, Ritaj. The wolf is with you. Jess is trying to decide whether he should go with you or whether he should go with Skaggy.
And I say, Jess, get your people out of here. Come on, let's go.
If Skaggy's going to try and burn something.
Oh, yeah. Trust that dwarf either.
And there's a small wooden outbuilding that's made of rough planks and has no windows that you can see, except for a barred opening set in the door.
Can I see inside?
It looks like there's somebody in there, and the door's
been. So I'm like, hey, I'm trying to get you out of here. Come on, let's go.
Okay, so you can try and break it. It's locked right now.
I'm just gonna push through it. I'm gonna hit it with my.
Go ahead and roll a 20.
Okay. I've got a strength of 17.
Yeah, that doesn't matter, dude.
So you smash the door pretty hard. It doesn't come open, but you see some of the things break. You can give it a try again if you want.
Sure. We'll get it one of these times. God.
That was even weaker. He's getting winded now.
You crack the door. You break the door, but all your knockings attract some spiders. You can roll a 20.
Fuck. Knock down.
And let me...
Fuck that guy. Oh, Howard, if you're not in Twitch chat, dude, we're having a fun time over there.
That's meta, man. Come on.
Yeah, I know. Sorry. It's all meta.
Yeah, you guys got to join the Twitch chat.
Well, Twitch what'd you chat. Get, Ritosh?
I got 16. Or... I don't know what I was rolling for.
Anish.
Oh yeah, then 17.
All right. So one of the spiders shoots a web thing at you and misses completely. It's your turn. There's four spiders coming towards you.
Boom! Are any of them close enough for me to attack with a sword?
No.
Okay, then I'll attack the closest one with a crossbow, and then I think my secondary action or whatever, I'm going to get my sword ready.
Okay.
So, 14...
Hits.
Hey, shit, it's been so long since I hit. I don't even know what a crossbow damage is.
All right. Let's see. For you, a crossbow.
I think it's a D8, right? Or a D10?
Heavy. It's a heavy. I don't
even have it on there for you.
That's 1D10, right?
Oh, shoot the bitch in the face.
And what do I add to this damage? Do I add my strength still?
Just a second. Let me grab.
Are you proficient in crossbow?
I don't think so.
And this was a heavy crossbow, right?
Yeah.
So it's a D10 plus 2.
Okay, so 7.
Okay.
Yeah, those things are pretty tough.
And you're by yourself.
Yep.
Like a boss. We're all sitting there, I'm talking to pirates, like,
And I'm like rubbing the ship. I'm like, dude, good construction here. Fucking, I'm like checking it out. I'm like,
Gaggy is an asshole because you left him.
I know.
Jess is with you, and he shoots at one and hits one with his bow. So then it's their turn for the rest. That one drops.
Wouldn't Skaggy and the others hear something going on?
Well, Skaggy. Well, just a second. So.
Okay.
No, I'm too involved with these pirates, dude. I'm fucking. I want to do shit. I'm fucking chilling.
He's just drinking some grog.
I know, dude. I'm like, I'm ready to have a beer with these guys. I'm like, yeah, what's fucking going on?
One of them drops like and bites. Right here, dude.
I know they're pirates, which I was not, but like, I'm still all about like ex-sailors, dude. That sounds really bad.
So one of them drops and bites Jess.
Ooh.
All right.
Wait, are they? They're not in the. Oh, they're still in the air, though. Okay.
Yeah. Two of them are in the air. Two of them are on the ground.
Yeah, I was thinking that they were coming to me on the ground for some reason.
All right. And I think that was all the actions for this round. So you can do initiatives.
All of us are...
And Skaggy, you hear a fight at, just as you're at the door. As you're about to enter the door... You can hear the fighting break out.
So what I want to do is I'm gonna hear the fight. I know Retosh went off, and I'm just like, ugh. I know he's gonna be in a mess. So I want to go into the ship, and I want to tell these guys, hey, we got some spider. I just run in there, and I'm like. Trying to tell everybody, oh my gosh, like, and I'm trying to relay these spiders, and then how I threw a dagger into the ass of one, and, like, it was a whole mess, and now this guy went off, and they're fighting these other spiders. We gotta go save them. Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Freaking so, telling a story.
I'm looking at fucking Skaggy.
There's some spiders on the motherfucking ship. Let's go kill them. That's all you gotta say.
We saw spiders coming in here, and I just turn around and I kind of fucking ignore them because, like,
all right.
I'm talking about
so,
like construction of the ship.
I know
ship,
Retosh is in trouble, so I'm going to help Retosh.
So I got Scar coming with me, or Car coming with me. So I'm gonna go.
Scar.
Well, yeah. So this round is the round where you're explaining quickly for a minute what's going on. So, the first spider misses with the web shooting at Retosh. What'd you get for initiative on this time?
13,
okay. The second one reaches you and bites you. And... oof. 6 damage.
Damn. Do I need to roll for...
And you need to roll a DC 12. So, a 20-sided dice. You gotta get 12 or higher. You can add Constitution. Your Constitution bonus takes you over.
Oh,
you're okay.
Boom.
So, that spider tries to bite your dog and bites.
Dog? He's a wolf, dude. Hold on. Big difference, Kelly.
The little puppy gets
bitten. Don't be a douchebag.
Don't downgrade him into a dog. Okay?
We already know how this GM feels about animals, okay? Yeah, like, that's already been established.
If you have a horny, the bitch is going to die. I'm just saying. I mean...
Yep. Never forget, motherfucker. Never forget.
Oh, you have an animal? It's dead.
All right. Retosh, you're up. No. Yeah, you haven't gone this round, did you?
No.
Go for it.
Come on. Oh, are they close? He bit me, right? So I'm using my my sword.
Yep.
Come on, son of a...
Yeah! Oh, crit that bitch. You.
Dang.
A sword up your ass, spider. Up
your ass. Spin your webs now, bitch.
He's doing like a little orc dance while he does it. He's like, hey, hey.
No. No.
You killed one. It is definitely dead.
Nice.
Oh.
The other one shoots a web at Jess and misses him. And he shoots an arrow and kills another one. You're down to two spiders.
So, am I there yet?
So, the door bursts open to the end, and Carr steps out. He's the only one stepping out, apparently.
By the way, swords are already drawn.
Skaggy's still trying to explain what's happening, and Godric's ignoring him.
No. Hold on. GM is fucking this up.
No. He's not fucking it up.
Carr.
Talking about it, and Godric was like, ah, fuck this guy.
No. I was like, Carr knew. He said, I don't
yeah,
give a fuck.
Exactly. Yeah, Carr understood what was going on, so Carr and I were going to go run off.
Right. Carr stepped out.
No. I'm following Carr.
Like, okay, you're following Carr.
No. Like, Carr is actually following me. I just ran in, did my two-sentence ramble, and turned around. And then I just assumed people...
Two cents.
Yeah.
All right.
He was like, bad, here,
you said
now.
What you were doing, it was like at least 10 sentences. So I don't know how that condensed.
No, what I said was like... What I said was 4 sentences, man. Maybe
oh,
when you,
I'm sorry, 4.
Maybe when you translate it to Asian, it's like 10
no,
sentences.
No, dude, you said like a fucking paragraph. Like, you were sitting there going, so guys, I threw a dagger, and there was this, and a spider, and he descended, and I'm all here, and blah, blah, blah. And you didn't even ask for help. You were telling a story, dude, of fucking nothing. And I shocked myself, and I tested in a weird spot, and I got damaged. It hurt really bad, but it felt so good at the same time. Like... What the fuck, dude?
See, it's a run on sentence, technically.
Retosh is getting attacked by spiders. We need to go help him.
Dude, that's
and
what he could have said. That's why fucking Godric doesn't give a fuck.
And that's why Carr came help, because he heard spiders war, done.
Yep, exactly.
Spiders killed, done.
So, in that last round, we were on our way, Kelly. So I don't know how timing works out.
You stepped out and you looked, and with some distance attacks, you can help. You won't be in range to do something.
Burn hands.
Oh, and I got to look here. Just a second.
Burn hands.
All right, so roll initiative, everybody.
Everybody. Godric's still in the
show. No, Godric's not. Yeah, he doesn't count as everybody yet.
Unless
sorry.
I'm fighting the pirates, but those are my brothers, so... Yeah,
oof! Man, that hurts.
Oh.
Oh, gosh.
You guys were really slow coming out of the ship.
Holy cow!
Oh, damn!
Oh, my gosh! That was...
Ooh, okay, so... Carr got a...
Five.
Five.
Oh, well, eight.
Seven, I think.
Yeah. Eight.
All right. Big old eight.
Not good. That's what that just said.
Okay.
That's not good.
Retosh, what do you have?
Eight.
Oh, yeah. And Godric's still in the building. Skaggy, what'd you get? Seven. Okay.
So yeah, this does not go well.
Well, maybe, hold on, maybe we'll get lucky and the GM rolls a one for initiative for the spiders, right?
Yeah, okay.
It hasn't happened
I did with one
yet.
Of them, actually. Nice. One of the spiders has a one.
Nice.
So
there's only two, so it's okay.
Now, on the other hand, I have to look at this real quick. Just a second.
FYI, I need to upgrade my fucking keyboard to a non-mechanical keyboard.
Agreed.
Fuck you.
Say what?
I thought you liked the click.
We got like Howard playing with his clickety-clackety balls. Godric typing on his mechanical keyboard shit.
Godric doesn't have a keyboard.
Carl and I are the only ones that aren't ADD during this whole thing.
Dude, you guys have fucking laptops. Like, fuck you, okay?
I don't have a laptop, dude. What are you talking about?
I know, I saw your beast.
You saw four large spiders running across the top of the web toward you guys. Whoa. And then a large burning bird flying above through the sky, and all the spiders scatter into various directions as the phoenix soars across the sky and disappears over the trees.
Say what, nigga?
But there's still the two spiders in front of you, and Carr gets to go first.
Oh, shit. Okay, so there's only two spiders left, and they're actually running away?
No, those two are still fighting, but all the reinforcements that were coming decided to go elsewhere when the bird...
Phoenix came in.
Yes.
Okay, so how close are the two spiders together, and how far away am I?
You are about 30 feet away.
So within striking distance, okay. And then how close together are they?
10 feet.
10 feet? Oh, damn, that sucks. Well... I will go after the closest one then, since I can't go after the other one.
Okay.
So that's a D20, correct?
Yep.
Right, let's roll. Holy shit. That's
didn't quite reach him in time.
Okay, and then with my second scimitar. Fuck.
What you get for bonuses?
He doesn't on his... Oh, yeah, on his second attack, he does. Because he's a whore.
I am a whore, and...
I'm such a hater.
I am a hater, dude. That's such bullshit.
Here's the sad part. I don't remember
good
what I
get. Good thing he's on our side. Remember, this is a co-op.
He's not on my side. Me and Carr have, like, this feud, dude.
Stop, dude. You know
it's
what I get.
It's a friendly feud.
I rolled a 10, but I think after the second roll...
You get all your proficiency, so I think you get
He has plus 7.
Yeah, plus 7.
You know you've secretly loved him ever since he slapped his...
Oh, I got 17 then.
Fuck up, dude.
So you have... Go ahead and roll damage.
Damage, and that's a 1d6, correct?
Yep.
And I got a 5.
Plus 5, 10.
Plus 5, 10. So I got 10.
And you killed another spider.
Godric, where you at, man?
Retosh, you're up.
I'm having a drink. Cheers. Tink. Fucking.
Retosh, you're up. One healthy spider left.
And as I notice them running out, I kind of go towards the door and I kind of like peer out. And I see what's going on. How many spiders are out there?
Right now, just one.
Oh, yeah. I see they have it in hand, and I totally turn back and start talking to these guys again.
Okay.
I got your back, dude. Don't worry.
Thanks, Carter.
Yeah, dude. And I periodically just kind of look out and see what's going on.
I got a 16, Kelly.
Hit? That hits.
Okay, so it's a...
Greatsword, 2d6 plus...
Greatsword, 2d6.
Believe.
2d6 plus
nope,
my
nope, Yeah, yeah. 2d6 plus 4.
Plus 4, right?
Yep.
Bam!
Oh, that's dead.
And you finish off another spider.
So, nice. Just
yeah, high five.
Outside the game, what the fuck would I would have done? I would have got there and you would have killed him and I would have been like, oh, I'm going to go talk to the pirates again. Fuck you guys. I know what I'm doing.
All right. So, the guy with you goes, thank you, thank you.
So Jess says thank you. Okay, now what?
Well, that was actually, no, Winston.
Winston? Oh, is he the... whatever he
one
is.
One of the pirates? Oh, no, the wizard dude?
He's the guy in the house that you went after, right?
Oh, that guy. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So that's all the spiders, Kelly? We the large ones were scared off, and then now everything's gone?
There's nothing around you right now. No more spiders, at least. You still see them running around the outside of the web, but they're away from you right now. Nothing is attacking.
Okay, so I'm going to ask Winston, I don't know if this was already covered, but do we know where the spiders came from? It was just overnight, they just showed up?
You do not. Car does.
Oh, okay.
So you're asking Winston where they came from, or?
Yeah, I'm asking Winston, but since Car can hear me, maybe we can tell me.
Okay, well, Winston says, they just showed up last night. This morning we woke up and there were webs everywhere and half the people were gone. And now there's a spider home southeast of here out in the forest, but everybody knows to avoid it and stay away from it. I don't know what would drive spiders like this out here. It's crazy.
So we can probably skip it. Right, and just kind of meta through it, but basically Carr would give us the background of what he knows, right? And he would mention that this guy drew a map for Godric. So then I'm going to recommend we go back to the ship, talk to Godric, and make our way to that spider's nest.
But do we... I was trying to figure out if we wanted to burn
things just here. I'll tell you what, I know where that is. I can lead you to it if you guys do one thing for me. When you guys leave, you guys got to take Jess and me, or Patience and me, with you. You got to take Patience and me with you. We got to get out of this town.
Done.
We're going to a dragon tomb. You coming with?
It's got to be better than here.
So I said, all right, let's go back to the ship. Let's grab Godric. Let's come up with a plan, and then let's take off and go after these spiders.
Is there a way for us to clear the spider web before we leave, or is that just kind of one of those things? It's either time or fire.
You know, thanks, Carr, because I've been trying to throw out my burning hands and burning down this whole thing the whole time. Nobody's been for it. You know.
Hold on. I didn't say it was about the fire. I just said, those are only two options. It's either time or fire.
So you should have the background of those two talking, of what they were talking about on the ship, right? So, it sounded like...
Well, I know what they said on the ship, but none of them described they all said that the spider webs came, quote-unquote, during the night, and they don't know how they got there.
Right, but what I'm saying is it sounds like to me that all this is from the nest, right? So the theory is if you kill the nest and kill the spiders there, they won't come back to the town, right?
Correct. But I want to know about this town, if there's something we can do to fix the town before we leave. As in, is there a way to get rid of the webbing without burning it down?
I don't know.
mean, you could try and crawl up the mast and cut it away, but that just make it fall down lower.
That's what I mean. Like, is it like something that we can cut around like the outside of the town and it eventually dissolves, or do we have to go to the place where it originated?
He can't tell you that, man, because if he tells you that, he tells you the secret. You're meta-ing. All you know is what you know in the game.
Well, that's what I'm asking. Like, okay, if we cut, like, in the game...
You just tell Kelly what you want to do. If you want to climb up the mast and cut it down, you can do that.
That's what I was saying. Either we get everybody out of the village, and then we just burn it down so we don't even...
How about we all get together as a group so I can get in this conversation?
Right. Like I've been saying for four times now, I think we should go back into the ship, talk to the group there, then you guys can throw out all your ideas, right?
Wait, how many people were in the village?
20? 40 total, but there's like 20 left.
40 total. Okay, 20 left, but there was a total of 40.
Yep.
Did we save the 20 already, or did we...
We've got like
one guy.
Well, we got Winston. There's the two pirates with you that you're drinking while we were fighting. Three, and then there's that wizard guy, Patience. So that's six. So we got like 14 more that we need to go grab and get out of here, and then we burn the place
down. Let's just go talk with the rest of the group. I'm not saying you guys have bad ideas, but let's throw them out to the whole group. So, Kelly, let's just pretend.
Yeah, let's go.
Let's just pretend we walked over and we're in the ship, Kelly.
All right. You guys are just arguing and you guys make your way over there. Skaggy finally gets everybody in the ship. Come on, car. Little shove in the cars. But should I climb the mast? It's kind of in the door. All right.
Here's the game plan. Apparently this is the game plan. Car, the giant lizard man, is going to climb up the fucking ship, cut down the spider web from the mast. Retosh is going to go Rambo his way through fucking town and save people. And then Godric's going to drink with some goddamn pirates. And then I'm here trying to corral people to go to the spider nest. Guys, this is a big clusterfuck right now. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I will help Retosh save the town. My thing was if we got everybody out of town, let's send them to the keep. Get rid of the town. Because, fuck it, let's face it. A town with 40 people is not worth... Really, is that really a town?
Yes, it is, you son of a bitch!
So now it's...
Really, 40 people? Really, a town?
I mean, seriously. Yes, they
are.
Is that
really a town? I will take my comment on Twitch. Thank you.
So, what's your plan?
Godric, bring some intelligence to this otherwise disaster.
Yes. So who's in the bar with me now?
Everyone's
in the bar with me. Okay.
Except the scholar who's still outside studying the spiders.
And that's Patience's dad, right?
Yep.
Okay. So we're getting everyone together, and before I even address you guys, I address the pirates because I feel more connected to them than everyone except Skaggy. So I kind of look and I ask them what they,
Hey, who let him out? Who let him out of there? He's supposed to be in jail. Winston, what the hell are you doing in here?
We're trying to save the town. That's the deal we made with Jess.
He was looting places.
I kind of lean in, and I go. In this crisis, can we kind of let that? You know, I mean, I kind of look down at his forearm, and you know, I recognize his tattoo, and I go, can we kind of let that go right now?
Winston goes, you know damn well I wasn't looting. You just don't like the competition. Did whatever you could while you had the strength to do it.
So I look at the pirates and I go, I know you guys got a nice ship here, but are you guys willing to kind of leave and maybe find a new home?
No, then we'll let the webs dry off. They'll be gone in 2 days and shouldn't be much of a problem. Just if we got to kill those damn dog spider things up there. Those are big, nasty bitches. And hopefully we can find the people. I'm just worried about where they are.
I feel we should go probably maybe house to house then. If they're so worried about the people, maybe we should go house to house.
Well, how do we know that people aren't there? How did Jess know that? How do we know half of them aren't there?
Jess didn't know that. That's news to him that they're missing.
So who told us that?
The people in the bar had said that.
Oh. So we know they're gone for sure.
So far from the people you've met, there's the crazy scholar who all he wants to do is find out more about the spiders. He seems to be in love with spiders. There's Jess, who is the hunter, and is the young hunter and his girlfriend, who he just wants to leave town with you guys. He said he'll take you to the spider's web, but you're going to stay and protect her, and he wants to get her out of this place. And you got the three pirates at the bar who they said that half the town is gone. There's about 20 people missing. And they locked up Winston for looting. Winston said he wasn't looting. He was looking for the people. He's going door to door to see who he could save and help. He's actually one of the council members of the town. And he owns the other pub in town, which is the Black Fly.
So I don't think we should. I mean, this is still their homes. So let's just go to the. I'm saying we go to the hole, the lair.
You want to go to the spider lair and kill off the spiders first?
Yeah. So we'll ask them. Like, I'm gonna ask the pirates. Like, you think you guys can handle the spiders that are here if we leave them here?
Yeah, Galen says he can handle anything. Nothing will come through the door.
And then Jess and Patience, are you guys coming with us, or what are you going to do?
Winston says he's going to go back to his place, which is Black Fly, and stay over there. And they kind of give him some dark looks, but he's going to go over to that place, and he'll take Jess with him, or Patience with him, while Jess goes with you guys to search for the spider nest.
Okay. And do you guys have any torches or gasoline or anything that we can use that might help us against the spiders?
I have a spell that I can do.
Yeah, but like I'd like to, maybe if I could do like a flaming arrow or something, that'd be good.
I'm sure we could use prestidigitatious, and I could light a torch and you could wrap some cloth and do that.
Yeah.
Okay. What was I gonna say? Okay, let's.
Yeah, we can create sparks with that.
Do we want to?
You also can light a fire, campfire.
Yeah, you can instantaneously light or snuff out a candle, a torch, or a small campfire.
I'm gonna ask the pirates if they have any. Actually, is the scholar there, or he's not in the room with us, right?
No, he's back out at his hut still.
Actually, though, I do like Retosh's thought. We should see if they do have some oil, because then we could grab some oil and we could potentially make, like, Molotov cocktails.
Yeah, I'm going to ask them if they have any weapons, and I'm also going to go ask the scholar if he knows of anything, any spider weaknesses that we can use.
Yep, I like that plan. So we're gonna ask around for weapons. Retosh is going to talk to the scholar. And then I'm gonna see if I can get my hands on any oil or anything that'll any liquid that'll burn.
They could sell you some lantern kerosene type stuff.
We're trying to save your town here.
Yeah, there's no cell, man. You pony that shit up or we'll leave you to the spiders. Place.
Yeah, I can just leave. I wanted to leave a long ass time ago.
Exactly.
I think it's like 2 hours ago I wanted to leave now. Like,
exactly. There's
that's a there's no, and some new friends. What are you talking about?
There's no fucking pay. Come on now.
They can give you one lantern. There might be some more lantern oil at the general store if you want to go over there.
Alright.
That's what they can give you.
We'll take his one lantern and then we're gonna go loot the store for more. I mean, okay. I'm not gonna tell him that, but I'm gonna fucking grab Carr, who can carry a bunch of shit. We're gonna go get some oil. We're gonna save this fucking town.
Okay. So they say that the general store is straight south of the front of the ship.
And Kelly, while they're doing that, I'm going to ask the scholar if he knows.
Godric, are you coming with us to get the oil?
So are you all going to go?
I feel like, dude,
spiders, come on, man. Don't leave me to get bitten on my ass again.
If Patrick's not role playing tonight, he's just real life to me. He's like, I'm drinking in the real. At home, but listen,
I would go with you, but I feel Godric knows you're going to just get kerosene, so he would stay and drink.
Oh, Carr would stay and drink. Are you kidding me?
Carr would stay and drink too, because Carr knows. See, so remember when I said Godric really likes Skaggy? He's starting to migrate towards Carr. Just saying, put a snap up your game, Skaggy.
Beer?
Friend,
I'm telling you, there's a bromance. Brewing there.
There is. Yep. The little guy and the big guy. We're going to make it happen.
So just straight south. It's right on the way leaving town, heading towards the
so,
spider's nest. So if you want to just hit the store on the way out.
Right. That's what we're
you still going to try and clean up the rest of the town first?
That makes sense. In that case, I'm going to go with Retosh to go talk to the scholar.
Okay. So the two of you are going over to the scholar first, and the rest of you are staying in the...
They're going to drink like a bunch of bitches.
Okay.
Excuse me. We're drinking like the hardcore.
Yeah, no, they're drinking Alizé and like little glasses with their fucking.
Sorry, excuse me. I'm drinking a Zima.
I have a wine cooler. My pinky's up, and I'm like, yes. No.
So
I use prestidigitation to use fucking. You know, I put That's So Fancy on in the background.
Howard, fancy.
Yep, that's what happens.
Howard, are we going to search for our leprechaun whistle to protect us from the spiders?
My granddaddy made it for me.
Sorry.
He's Irish.
So you see there the Grill, the doctor, is like, yes, what can I do for you?
You seem to be really interested in these spiders. Do you know of any weaknesses they might have that we can use against them?
They don't like birds.
Fucking Eleanor laughed. I'm so angry right now.
But otherwise, they're quite fascinating. They're just... I would love to go see where they are. Are you guys heading toward the nest? I'd love to go with you to the nest. I could take so many notes and some samples, and I could get... Now, you aren't planning on hurting them, are you?
We're going to kill them all.
They're just scared. You know, just rub their thoraxes. They'll calm down.
They just blanketed your town in webs, and we're going to eat all of you. Half of you are missing. What's wrong with you?
You know, if they really come at you next time, just try to lay it down on your back and play like you're dead. They'll leave you right alone.
We're gonna go kill them all, and you're not coming with us.
What? Well, can you at least bring me back some samples from each one you kill?
Yes.
What are we gonna? What are we gonna get for it?
Yeah, it might be worth that. Hang on, just a second. just a second. And he goes inside, he starts digging through her, I got two potions here. Now I gotta keep this one. But these two, I can trade you these two. Would you want to trade a potion of cure light wounds or a potion of remove paralysis? I could give you these two if you promise to give me at least 20 samples.
20 samples of what?
Whatever you find. I could use a couple thoraxes. I could use a mandible. At least one of the legs of each time. If you see different types of spider web, could you bring back the web? The web itself. That stuff. That's so beautiful, isn't it? You could just make a blanket out of this stuff. You know that?
Man, you got like a football field worth of web all around you.
There's webs everywhere. So we'll hook you up with that. And then there's also at least 4 thoraxes, 8 mandibles, and a bunch of legs over there. That will just take the potions now. You can go play with that.
If you're going to the nest, though, bring back. You can have these now, but you got to bring back some more goodies. Samples of everything you find, okay? If you see some spider poop, that's good, too. Bring some of that back.
All right. We'll take care of it.
Here's some empty jars. You need you like 3 empty jars.
You have any acid, by any chance?
No, I used that already.
I've had good experience with these jars and acid, so I was just hoping you might have some.
Yeah, with our fucking pansy throwing arms, dude. Yeah.
All right, we'll see what we can do.
And remember, they're just scared. That's the only reason they come at you. If you just rub their thoraxes, they'll calm right down.
Yep. So hold on. I've got some intelligence, Kelly. I'm looking at this guy. Like, what are you talking about? They're just scared. And you just rub their belly, they'll calm down. I walked into a building and these spiders just jumped down on top of me for no reason.
You're saying that to him?
Yeah.
Well, they're just trying to protect their own. That's all. You know, if you would have laid down and played dead, I'm sure they would have just ignored you and walked right over you.
I'm sure.
No, the thing wrapped me up. It was going to have me for lunch.
It was just keeping you warm.
Hold on.
No, they do tend to store things for a little while.
I'm kind of sniffing this dude. He's not checking out to me at all. So hold on 1 second here. Can I speak? So I can speak orc. So I'm gonna turn to Retosh and I'm gonna speak in orc and I'm gonna say I something fishy is going on here. Let's get out of here.
And he just turns around and puts a spyglass up. He's looking at the spiders up above.
All right. Are we walking out of there, Retosh?
Do you want to throw him into the jail Winston was in?
Well, you can't. The door's broke.
Yeah. That's what I was wondering. I can't remember if I broke it or not.
So we walk out of the building, Kelly, and then I want to talk to Retosh for a minute. I'm like, man.
Did you take the two potions?
Yes.
Yes. I'm like, man, I don't trust these potions. I don't trust this dude. Like, he's way too into these spiders. Why does he care more about these spiders that are taking over his town than he does anybody else?
I think he's just crazy.
Cray cray.
Something's fishy here, man. I don't like this.
Am I with Carr again? Am I with the Cardigan?
So the two of you guys are still at the bar, from my understanding.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, Carr's going to sleep. He's obviously passing out. I mean, I have to get way down here to be like.
You know, the sad part is that she'd be like sitting on my couch, like all the way back.
Dude, I'm like breaking my neck down here, like.
So, you guys ready to, what you doing? You guys combined in one group again, heading south, or?
I'm calling cliffhanger. We go back to the bar and decide what we're going to do, but I'm calling cliffhanger on this. I got to go to bed.
Hey, all right. Kelly, was that a potion of healing? Is that what it was?
Cure light wounds, yep. Potion of healing.
And cure paralyzed.
No, it wasn't, Retosh. That is a potion that's going to turn your ass into a giant fucking spider. That's what that is.
We can test it out on Godric like he made me sip acid.
Dude, I already have no hair, okay? Fucking Halinor. Oh, they're scared of birds. Our bird man went away. Fucking whore. God damn you, Kelly. So, I guess we'll wrap it here because Skaggy is has a vagina and needs to go to bed. No, I'm playing with you. Everyone, thanks for watching. Please follow the channel. We normally do Thursdays at about 8 o'clock, 8:30 sometime because Retosh. But we love him anyway. Yeah, thanks for watching and have a good night.
Good night.
Not all.
Bye. Bye.